Hello, in this video I will show all of the amazing workflows and tools the Pegasus team have produced. Our goal was to produce a detailed open world environment and make use of key Unreal 5 features such as nanite virtualized geometry and nanite landscapes. I want to show you how Houdini helped us reach that goal and tackle the many production challenges we faced when creating such a large environment in a short space of time. We'll be releasing project files with the video series, and in the near future we hope to release the Unreal project along with all of the digital assets. To begin with, I wanted to provide some foundational information such as setting up a Houdini package file and how it can be used with the project folder structure and enable a team to collaborate and stay organized. I also touch on the use of version control software and explain versioning digital assets so that you can have an idea of how the Pegasus team were able to collaborate and work together. Then we have the landscape. This was really the start of Project Pegasus and formed the foundation of the whole project. I'll walk you through the creation of the landscape and how Houdini engine and set and sync were used to make changes and iterate quickly during the designing process. George will demonstrate the pipeline he developed for detailing the landscape, taking my base landscape and applying additional levels of procedural detail and manual edits. George will also explore the landscape material he developed, the use of world partition with Houdini engine, and using Unreal Nanite landscapes. George will also explore techniques for scattering foliage and generating procedural paths. To add even more detail to the environment, I will demonstrate how I used Houdini and tops to generate procedural cliffs across the entire island. The workflow made use of Nanite and produced highly detailed geometry, so I also explain the challenges of importing this amount of data into Unreal. Then we have the pile tool, a digital asset that can pile up objects or create piles of debris. This will demonstrate how Houdini can be used to create tools that can be used directly inside Houdini or in Unreal with Houdini engine. Next, we have a workflow for using tops to generate nanite props. I will demonstrate how we can take a basic input mesh and apply a procedural detail, and then use a tops network to automate generating and exporting additional variations. For architecture, Fiker explores techniques he used to generate the buildings for Project Pegasus. I'll use a PCG network in Unreal to sample an area of the landscape and reference this into Houdini to Boolean input geometry and place geometry that can follow the landscape. Fiker will also demonstrate techniques for storing static mesh information in a data table, which can then be referenced into a digital asset. This is particularly useful when dealing with nanite geometry, where referencing and sending the geometry to and from Houdini can be particularly time consuming. Alex will discuss how Houdini tools were used to create the different cloudscapes, and particularly the new Houdini 20 cloud tools. The clouds went through a number of iterations, and during production, Epic released Unreal 5.3 with support for importing VDBs. So in future videos, Alex will be discussing the implementation of the clouds in Unreal. Lastly, we have Flora. Flora is a set of prototype foliage tools. George and Fiker developed these tools, and Tillman took on the challenge of using these very early tools to produce the foliage for Project Pegasus. While Flora is in very early development, we still wanted to share the work that we've done. Flora aims to allow the modelling of vegetation in a natural and realistic way, following the rules observed in nature. Tillman will explain his initial exploration using the Flora tools, and what he learned along the way, understanding and observing nature and applying that to his work in Houdini. We'll be releasing the Project Pegasus content over the coming weeks, beginning with the landscape workflows. The team has put a lot of hard work into Project Pegasus, but there's still so much more we'd still love to talk about. So I hope to continue developing Pegasus even further, releasing more content in the future. So I hope you enjoy this. Thank you for watching.